Good morning, guys. Welcome back. It's another horrible rainy day here in Belfast, and I am working once again in the shed on a little Steam model. Now, this one, unlike the majority of the stuff I play with, is not a production model. This is a favour for another YouTuber. Shout out to UK Scale Modeler, chap I've known for a lot of years. One of my own subscriptions is to his channel. I do it in the winter months when it's horrible outside. One of the things I've done over the years is making a lot of scale models of aeroplanes. And now Ian organises, has over the years organised a lot of group builds and so on through YouTube. So if that's your kind of thing, jump over to his channel. I'll link him in the description below. But yeah, shout out to Ian. And I noticed you haven't done an awful lot of stuff recently, but it'd be good to see you back real soon. Now this is a model that was made by his dad a lot of years ago. I'll tell you what I know about it. He made two, one for him, one for his brother. It seems to be an original take on the very popular Polly model, which can be found in Tubal Cain's book, Building Simple Model Steam Engines, I think it was called. I'll just cut a picture of that in here. There you go. So that's the book. What he's done, as far as I can see, is basically turned the cylinder the other way up and put the flywheel at the top, which to my mind works a lot better for a number of reasons. Most specifically, it means that you can put oil into the top of the cylinder rather than it just falling straight out. So from a functional perspective, that should work better. Now, this hasn't been run for a lot of years and is pretty seized up. But just looking over it, I think there's a few things we're going to need to do. Not a lot that needs to be done before it can be steamed up. But, you know, from a functional perspective, it should be a relatively straightforward exercise. In here, on the drain port, the fibre washer, as you can see in there, zoom in on that. The fibre washer itself has cracked, and at least half of it's fallen away. A bit of verdigris around the outside there. We'll clean that up and see what's going on. The drain washer is the drain port screw itself is pretty chewed up, so I'll use a small needle file, just clean that up as best we can. If it was my own model, I'd probably silver solder a bar across to make it a little bit easier to extract. Certainly instead of reaching into a box of bits. On the original Mammod models, those little drain ports have horns like this kind of thing. So, I'd say if it was my model, I'd probably just put a little bar into the top of that slot and silver solder it on just to make it easier to extract. But I want to keep this faithful to the original because I say I'm really rather impressed with the quality of the machining on this. There's some lovely little features and, as I say, enhancements on the original design for Polly that you'll find in Tubal Cain's book. There are some very, very nice features for such a simple engine. For instance, the axle itself has a sleeve, a little brass sleeve, so it's a metal axle into, unlike the Mammods, which were basically just a hole in some metal, piece of brass through which the steel axle spins. This one has a retaining sleeve. There is a little oil filler port on the top of that. Now that's blocked up. That's another thing that we need to sort out as part of the restoration here. The burner itself is a little Metz burner, beautifully engineered little thing. There'll be with the wicks pressed flat on the top there rather than sitting proud, there will be about half to three quarters of an inch of flame. It should be complete combustion, so that'll keep it nice and clean moving forward. So that's a lovely little burner. Of course, this type of boiler has the chimney running straight the way through it, so having three small flames rather than one big one up the middle means that the majority of the heat is at least being offered to the bottom of the boiler before going straight up the chimney. I noticed from the base that there is some discoloration you can see here. Now what that's been caused by is spray drips coming out of the exhaust. So we'll give it a little exhaust drain into a into a little bowl. I'm going to free up the piston. The piston itself is pretty seized, but that should be easy enough to get out. Now, another nice thing about this, I'm not sure if this is true to the original design or not, but there are a couple of nuts on here onto the trunnion spring, so you can adjust the tension. That's a real nice touch. It also makes it very, very easy to remove rather than the typical Mammod or Lasco style trunnion bolt. I have a spare here which just spins under compression there into the back of the mounting plate, as I've ably demonstrated there. Allows you to drop it very easily on the floor as you're trying to put it back together. So yeah, very nice little adaption there to keep things super simple when it comes to assembling and disassembling and indeed tensioning the spring for the wobble cylinder there. Very nice. It is only a single acting cylinder. Really nicely machined carrier there for the crankshaft. So other than that, needs a new fibre washer at the top on the steam pressure relief valve. Where are we? So we need to clear the oil port, we need to polish the cylinder. The whole thing could do with a good clean up, although it's metallic gold paint on the base. I'm not going to touch that. I'm going to try and keep us far away from affecting the original appearance of this as is possible. So yeah, we'll just give the get rid of the verdigris, get rid of lime scale. There's a lot of lime scale. It was used with normal tap water, as most of these models were, at least at some point in their life. So yeah, that's the list. We'll see as we go. We'll check the pressure relief valve works, and get it steamed up. Oh, one other thing, the paint on the flywheel, certainly on this side, is pretty chipped and cracked, indeed coming off in a number of places here. So what I'm going to do with that, whilst we take the flywheel off, the other side's okay, but I'm going to do this properly whilst we have it disassembled and give that a good clean and polish. I'm going to use some proper anti-rust metal primer on this section in the middle. Then I'm going to use enamel spray paint, a red workshop red spray paint, to refinish the red section, and then using emery paper flat on the deck, clean it back for this surface here, polish the outside, and then refit. There isn't any eccentrics or anything we need to worry about, just a really, really nicely engineered take on the original poly steam engine. So we're stay tuned. I'm going to speed up quite a lot of this video, I think, let's crack on, see if we can get this thing steamed up. So the first order of business then, let's have a little look and see what's going on inside the piston. This is actually seized, as I mentioned, so we need to free that up. In order to do that, I'm going to have to actually remove this from the model. Now, it is going to be possible, as with all these models, the intention is you should sort of spin it forwards, take the piston out, put some steam oil on the piston, and then stick it back in. This one, it's a really tight fit here around the crank pin, which I really actually prefer to the original sort of wobble cylinders. It's very solidly built, and being this orientation, you can just put a few drips of steam oil into the top of here and work it gradually in. But I think what's happened here is it's probably sat for a while with some water in the cylinder, or it's lime scaled up or whatever, so we'll take this apart. Now I notice also on the outside of these two pinch knots here. The outer one has actually been beveled. Some lovely attention to detail on this. So the inside of it is flat and the outside is beveled, so I need to make sure these go back in the right order. I'm just going to lay these down on the bench here in the order that they come off. So that first beveled nut, second one with a washer immediately after it, then the spring, then a washer. Okay, so I should now be able to take this out of the front, which I can. First thing I'm going to do here is just look to see if there's any marks. Now this will have worn in, so the orientation of the cylinder is really important. Don't want to suddenly go putting it in backwards, so I'm gonna just use a Sharpie here to identify the back. Very subtle, it'll never be seen from the front, but there's no way that I can mistake which way around that goes when it's going back into the onto the crank pin. Let's open this up. It's not too bad. Needs a good polish, as does the inside of the cylinder. That's no big deal. A little bit of rust. I think that may be made of stainless actually, so that's fine. All good. Importantly, know that we know which side is the back. So polish that up with a bit of Brasso in a moment. The flywheel itself is held on with a 2.5 millimeter, or imperial equivalent, but 2.5 millimeter is an exact fit. So that's the flywheel. You can see here paint's really quite chipped on that, so we'll strip that down with the usual paint stripper. Anyone who watched the Valesco reconditioning recently will know that I use this stuff wrapped in cling film, likewise to get rid of the lime scale from the engine. I use stuff that is designed for coffee machines, this stuff. So there's two chemicals on the list, so that's all good. Now this is what I was talking about with a beautifully engineered little brass sleeve here for the steel crankshaft to go through. So I shall need to just clean that through. Give this a good polish, but doesn't seem to be any problems with that, except that it needs freeing up a little. That's not too bad actually. But anyway, as I say, we shall just clear the oil port so that oil can go straight down through that little section at the top there into this sleeve and lubricate the crankshaft, reduce friction there. So that's another part done. There's no regulator valves or anything else to worry about. Of course, you can see a little bit of corrosion here, just for a degree build up. That needs to be a perfectly polished surface. Likewise on this side, this needs to be perfectly polished because that face rubs against that face, and as you'll know with these type of engines, the steam goes in one hole, pushes piston around, and on the return stroke it moves over, and the hole is presented then to the exhaust. This is, as I say, really nicely put together. Okay, so what have we got next? Next thing on the list is super easy. If you have one of these, a bag of spare fibre washers for these particular models, I am hopeful that if we can just get these two fibre washers out, it'll be a straight like for like swap. So let's have a look. Nice big screwdriver required. Ooh, it's a bit crunchy. There's a lot of limescale going on here. Okay, the first order of business then needs to be decrusting the boiler. Wow. Well, it is a predictable fibre washer at least. So, there you go, new fibre washer on that. Perfect. One down. It should be a standard. This looks like a replacement part that's been built in, so this is going to be a standard, I'm guessing, 3/8 inch Mammod, very skinny fibre washer on that. Yeah, again, pretty much a like for like. These are genuine replacement parts from Mammod, so again, it all needs. Let's just check that works. The O-ring's okay. Still rubbery enough in the top there, so I don't need to worry about replacing that just yet. New washer on the bottom. Spring moves freely, although it's full of limescale again. So now I'll pop that back in for now. So that's two things off the list straight away. So let's, before we do anything else, sort out the lubrication, polish up the faces of the wobbler. And see if we can get this thing into steam, and that will let us know if there's any other issues. But to be fair, there's only one solder joint at the top here and another one down here that could possibly be wrong. So yeah, I think we should be pretty much back in business. After that, it's all cosmetic, just Brasso and Brasso emery paper and a needle file to clean up the groove in the front of the fill level drain port. Well, one other thing worthy of mention is that as I looked at this, and if you can see it particularly clearly, but in here during the assembly process, you can see it there, it's got a little bit of silver solder that's managed to creep across the hole there, which is half blocking the steam port and, at least in theory, reducing the power. Because it's limiting the amount of steam that can flow through, so we can improve the power of this model just by pushing that over. And there you go, so hopefully that will help. Right, let's get the Brasso out, get this cleaned up and shiny, some distilled water into the engine, and we'll get it fired up. Okay, that'll do for now. So let's reassemble this. Marking on the inside of the hole there in the black, so that is the back face. Still a tiny little bit stiff. To do that, we'll put a drop of steam oil in now. One of the things I like about this model, that's an improvement over the original design in my humble opinion, is that the position of the cylinder means that it is easier to lubricate. You just put a spot of steam oil in the top of the cylinder with it in position like this. Of course it pulls around the cylinder, so as you then move it up and down just by rotating the flywheel, you're lubricating the whole stroke of the cylinder. Let's see if this is still good. There should be a put my finger over the steam hole. Beautiful, nothing wrong with this at all, just a little bit seized up. That should fall under its own weight. Yeah, that was seized up a minute ago. Happy days. Alright, so I'm going to put a spot of oil on this surface here as well. So that will lubricate this joint. Let's remove all opportunities for friction in the whole assembly. That'll do. Oops, falling down. There's a boot there, sorry about that. Okay, so this piece here is stainless. Brasso is brilliant stuff for cleaning up, specifically brass, copper, stainless steel and chrome. So it should do an admirable job, there you go, of cleaning that crankshaft. Absolutely lovely. Now I'll strip this down and polish it properly once we are sure that it's running okay. But next on the order of business was to clear out the oil port here. How are we going to do this? It's just drilled straight down through the top there, so not keen on the idea of using a paperclip if I can possibly help it, because this is brass and paperclip being made of steel, it could scratch it. I'm going to use a piece of solder instead. This is just normal solder. So I'll just try and poke down the grease and oil here. It is fairly blocked. We'll see when this breaks through into the sleeve below. good measure, give it a spot of oil, and direct into the little sleeve there. Crankshaft back in. So now we can stick it back together. Again, making absolutely certain that we've got this the right way around. A bit more oil just here on the crank pin itself. Basically, with these models, the trick is just to get rid of friction as much as you possibly can. Anyway, not always possible to eradicate it completely, but just aim to minimize it absolutely as much as is possible, and oil them up before you run the models. Oh, that's running lovely now. Okay, so let's just reassemble the trunnion bolt spring assembly. So washer goes on, then the spring, then a washer, then the first pinch bolt. Second one, this one's the one that's beveled. Just nip those together, and I'll just do it finger tight for now. Okay, so the flywheel itself can go back on as is for now. Oh, that's much better. Let's turn our attention now to the little Metz burner. Now the wicks I think are the right height there. That should give us about half an inch to 3/4 of an inch of flame. Just going to use a little funnel here just to put a splash of Metz in. Always be careful with this stuff. Doesn't need a mad lot in there. Lovely thing about these little burners is that they don't need a mad lot of fuel. Tiny little splash is more than enough. And these used to be called penny stoves. If you search in YouTube for penny stove, you'll see lots of people making them out of the sort of the bottom of drinks cans, that kind of thing. The idea is that instead of this being able to burn in the middle, when it gets hot, vapor will come up through that. You basically fill it up through the hole in the middle and then put a penny on top of that, so that the only way that it can burn is through one of the in this case, three wicks. So I'll just find a penny, although I suspect on this modern pennies are probably going to be a little bit too big for that. Maybe we'll use an old halfpenny, may have some around somewhere. And the point about this, by the way, is if the fuel is vaporizing and coming up through that hole in the middle. Of course, the chimney being straight up the middle, all of the fuel that's burning in the middle, the heat's being wasted. So I'm just going to use a 5p here, in fact, to cover that hole up. As I say, the concept of a penny stove isn't new, but that means that when it's in situ, the only way that the mass can burn is through the wick, which is going to heat the bottom of the boiler. Lovely. So let's get some water in it. Take out the fill port in the side, catch the drips, basically squirt water in until it squirts out. Quite so easy to see that the lights on. If I turn them off, you can see three lovely little flames there. Now if you have the wicks too high, you will end up with incomplete combustion. They're doing just lovely. So we'll get that in there. I mean, though you might think it's not going to be producing a lot of heat, that is uncomfortably hot for my hand there. So we'll pop those in. And keep an eye on it as it steams up. Okay, a few minutes have gone by now and it's just starting to come to the boil. So before it does, and in order to catch any condensation, I'm just going to put a little temporary drain on the exhaust here, just a little piece of rubber airline tubing into a bowl. That should catch any drips, stop them going on the base. I think that's about right for this model, actually. Okay, it's coming up to steam now, and you can see we have a drip. That drip is the pipe into the end sleeve here, so I'll need to put some fresh solder into that joint. But you can see it's starting to try and work now. First thing that happens when the steam gets into a cold cylinder is it immediately condenses, and what's going on with this assembly here, it's quite a big heat sink, hence the need to catch the drips. Now we are getting to the point where it may well fire up, seeing some bubbles coming up at the top here. Beautiful. Well, it runs. It runs smoothly. Sweet. Okay, so cosmetics now, and one very, very important functional detail. It was having problems there, building up steam quickly enough to replace the stain that was being used by the piston. And that is because of the build-up of limescale in the boiler. So I'm going to get that cleaned out now. As I've mentioned before, and as you've seen me do on other videos, I'm going to use this stuff, Quick Descaler. It's designed for coffee machines. It's absolutely fine in these models. I know a lot of people swear by vinegar and so on, which is, yeah, that's fine. You know, vinegar works. Point is, you don't leave it in overnight, right? So you put the stuff in, check on it regularly, and once the limescale has disappeared, get it out of there and wash it out very quickly. Just as I say, don't leave it in there an unnecessary amount of time and you won't have any problems at all. The other thing I need to do, I just need to quickly put a little brazing torch on there just to melt that solder seal, repair that joint that was dripping very slightly. I'm going to put a little spring clip around the end of this plastic rubber hose, because the thing, when it's a cold cylinder, does very definitely produce a lot of condensation, so we'll get that out of there as quickly as we can. And the flywheel as well. I shall, as I've done before, and if you want to see the process for that, have a look at my Velasco D12 restoration videos. I won't go over the same content again, but I'm going to be basically using this stuff. So put a good thick layer of that all around the component. I'm going to then wrap it in cling film, leave it for an hour or two. It'll wash back down to clean metal. Then going to use an anti-rust primer or a body shop primer, one or the other, followed by some workshop red enamel spray paint. That'll do a lovely job of the flywheel there. What else? I think that's very, very nearly us. As I say, the only issue at this point with it running is it can't generate steam fast enough, because the little burner can't put enough heat actually into the water, because there's a shroud of limescale around the inside. And then after that, it's just touch it up with Brasso, give it a good polish, and we're good to go. So yeah, that's very, very, very pleasing little outcome there. A lovely little model, very, very nicely machined. Particularly impressed with this piece. I really do like the way that that's been put together. Good stuff. Right, so the next time you see this, it'll be all nice and shiny. But in the meantime, all there is left to do is thank you for watching. Definitely check out UK Scale Modeler's channel. I think he's currently taking a bit of a hiatus, but he'll be back soon enough. Certainly a lot of very, very good content on there in relation to scale modelling. So if the sort of FX and Revell type models are your type of thing, you're not already subscribed, I would strongly encourage you to have a look. Certainly a lot of content in there. So that's it for today, guys. Thank you very much for watching. I'll probably post a short of the slow-mo just to show you what this looks like once it's all nice and shiny. In the meantime, take it easy. Thanks very much for watching. Have a great day, and I'll catch you next time. Cheers.